My name's Blake Worrall-Thompson. I'm the owner and director of Raw Solutions, a high-end personal training business based in Sydney, both in Bondi Junction and Double Bay. And I was Ruby's personal trainer while she was in Sydney promoting her new book, Ruby, and also her reality weight loss show, Ruby, My Australian Adventures. I had a chance to spend a week with Ruby tackling all that Sydney had to offer, including Macquarie's chair, sailing along the harbour, boxing, and the grand finale, which was the harbour climb.
You Ruby?
Yeah.
Blake, how you doing?
Blake, how are you?
Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
So, bit of a rundown. Where are we at? What are we doing this week?
I'm so excited to be here and I want to see the scenery. I want to have so much fun. And I'm hoping that you could take me places that I could work out and plus see the scenery. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
And do some fun stuff. But my goal is to lose 10 pounds this week.
Day one was an intro with Ruby and George. I hadn't met them, they hadn't met me previously, so it was a chance for us to sit down and have a bit of a chat and work out what Ruby was capable of doing and what she wasn't. And then we went on a brief walk around the city of Sydney to give her a little look at what Sydney's got to offer.
What are some fun things that would make it interesting for me?
Definitely got to get out and do some walking, see Sydney. We're hoping maybe the Sydney Harbour Bridge. Have you seen a picture of it? Unbelievable view up there. So we want to, at the end of the week, be able to get her to climb Sydney Harbour Bridge.
That is scary.
It's Australia. My job's to keep Ruby on track while she's away, which is a really hard part. So for the next week, whip her into shape and see that she gets back on that flight in good form.
Day two was based around Macquarie's chair. Both Georgia and Ruby were extremely keen to see Macquarie's chairs. They'd heard a lot about it. So we did a boxing session around Macquarie's chair and it was their first chance to have a look at the bridge and prep themselves up for day five.
Opera house, that is gorgeous.
Holy
cow. That is beautiful.
That's what I've
George,
been wanting to see.
George, look at it.
On the top.
No, there's not.
There is people on the top. There's a whole row of them down next to the Australian flag. Can you see all the little people next to it or not?
Those are people or statues?
Those what? Are people standing on top of that.
They look like little tiny things?
They are people.
Why are they up there?
You can walk across it.
Are they crazy?
There's another group coming up the side, two groups.
That's kind of insane. Have you ever done that?
No.
Would you?
Yes. No. If you do it.
I can't do that. Have you lost your mind? I don't think people understand what a challenge it is for me to do that bridge. I have all this weight on regular sized joints. My knees already hurt like crazy just climbing regular stairs.
In the whole weight loss scheme of things, you're going to have challenges all the time, and to be able to break them down gives you more confidence to take on the next challenge. So something like the Harbour Bridge, which isn't easy, to be able to break that challenge would, you know, set her in good stead to be able to break challenges that are still to come in terms of her weight loss. My major concern for Ruby is her knees. At this stage, that is her limiting factor in terms of how far she can get.
11, 12, 12.
Woo!
So if we can do some basic things to strengthen her core and the walking, which is going to help strengthen her legs, we'll be able to get past that issue and get her to climb that bridge.
40, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. All right, we're working down. Do we want that 10 pounds this week?
Yes.
Excellent, let's go. 18.
What?
2, 3, 4,
we're not done?
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
You're kidding?
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Excellent.
Day three gave us a chance to get out on the water and have a look at Sydney from a different angle.
How was the sails?
We're going to mast them.
What?
We're going to put them up as well.
Let's go.
Let's go.
I've never heard
before. Sailing's nowhere near as easy as it sounds. If you're pulling the ropes, you're going to be burning those calories. I think Ruby's in for a little bit of a surprise.
Ruby and Georgia hadn't been on the Sydney Harbour before. Gave Ruby and Georgia a good chance to see another view of Sydney and also get a solid workout in pulling in the reins and running the show on the boat.
See, I promise. 1 second.
You did it.
Thanks, girls.
I gotta get rest about it.
People up on that
good.
Bridge.
All the way up.
That's insanity.
That's us.
No, that's you, Blake.
That's all us. You, Blake.
That's us.
Yeah, yeah. That's you.
Ruby, if you can conquer the bridge, you've conquered Australia.
Nuh-uh.
Look at them.
Blake will not let up about that bridge, no matter what I say.
Day four was again based around the Harbour Bridge, just prepping up Ruby for day five.
There's our bridge for tomorrow.
Isn't that walking that bridge?
Absolutely, just
back
up here.
Imagine
the view. Look at it, all of Sydney.
I can see it right here.
You won't get anywhere near is what you're going to get up there. That will help you lose the 10 pounds.
That's not going to help me lose
That's the best workout. That is the best workout you'll ever do.
Yeah, I'll never be able to work out again.
You'll never get a calorie burner like walking the bridge.
Day five was the grand finale with the Harbour Bridge climb. We'd been prepping Ruby up all week and making sure she was as strong as possible to complete the task, which she wanted to do so badly.
Everything is tearing up on me.
She's only done a few, you know, flights of stairs in previously. It's an unbelievable effort.
Oh, God. Where's the destination?
The flags.
At the top of the flags.
How many stairs have I taken?
About 500.
500.
Ruby definitely didn't think she was going to achieve and was very nervous throughout the course of the 5 days. And Georgia pulled out only hours before. Ruby, with the rest of the team, was capable of conquering that bridge. Few little issues on the way back down with her knees, but absolutely dominated the Harbour Bridge climb and hopped back on that flight knowing that she'd done all she could in Australia.
Well, you got 20 steps left. 10 there, and you're done.
God.
Yes. Pump up that last 10. Let's get all of them. That's it. Yes.
Woo!
Yes.
Good for you. You did it.
Well done.
You did it.
Unbelievable. This is it, Reeves. Amazing. We worked together to push each other up. My stomach was turning and her knees were hurting, so we managed to talk each other up and make sure we got up here.
The week I spent with Ruby was an absolute delight. She was able to conquer everything that was set for her in all challenges. What impressed me most was just the ability for her to take on whatever I threw at her, and she completed it all with flying colours. With 160 kilos, a lot of the goals that were set were far from easy, but she was prepared to tackle everything. My goals with Ruby were to challenge her like she'd never been challenged before. Although she'd done very well in getting herself from 320 kilos to 160, I still felt that she needed to be challenged regularly to keep her motivated and on track to reach that goal of 100 kilos. My goal for the week was to give her a good insight as to what Australia had to offer and also a bit of Australian culture. Although she's still got a long way to go in her weight loss journey, the fact that she was able to break down a lot of the large challenges that were set will put her in good stead for the future. I know she wants to get down below 100 kilos. For that to happen, she constantly needs to be challenging herself and breaking these goals that she did so well in Sydney. None of these feats are all that easy, and obviously at 160 kilos, it makes them extremely challenging, but I've seen what Ruby's capable of. I look forward to seeing her complete all these tasks.